Julia Gillard said it would never happen under her leadership. But today, the carbon tax became a reality after passing its final hurdle in the Senate.
TEN's political editor Hugh Rimmerton is in Canberra now. And Hugh, most Australians might hate this tax, but there's no escaping it now.
It seems that is the truth, Sandra. It's been a long time coming. Paul Keating was Prime Minister when there was first the serious debate about getting something done about carbon pollution. 37 government inquiries, so much political pain. Well, it has finally gone through the Senate, and Labor is determined to make it stick no matter who wins the next election.
Pursuant to order.
The public galleries loved it.
Order.
The opposition had put up a final fight.
It's absurd to believe that this will do anything to the temperature of the globe.
But the Greens' numbers were enough to put it through the Senate. The carbon tax is on its way into law, and a new world begins from July next year.
This is one of the great Labor reforms.
People like it. They're happy about it.
It's one of those days where you do realise that leaders and parliamentarians, despite all the bad press we sometimes get, can actually do the right thing for the country.
It's the greatest sellout since Judas Iscariot took 30 pieces of silver.
The coalition claims this legislation will destroy Labor.
At the next election, they will be waiting for you.
Tony Abbott's in London, missing out on the final act of this defining issue.
What a spineless retreat.
But the opposition affirmed his determination to destroy the carbon price.
The next election will be a referendum on the carbon tax. Mm.
But even a coalition win wouldn't guarantee its repeal. The Senate is still likely to be held by Labor and the Greens.
Will you accept the verdict of the Australian people after the next election?
This is our package. We will support our package. We will support it today, we will support it tomorrow, we will support it in a year's time, 5 years' time, 10 years' time. We will support our package.
Labor's been enjoying a quiet resurgence of late. The latest news poll shows the government would still be wiped out. But take a look at the numbers.
Since September, the gap has narrowed from 18 points to 6. Julia Gillard is back at level pegging as preferred Prime Minister, although in truth we don't like either of the leaders. Tony Abbott's disapproval rating is 57, a terrible result, except that Ms Gillard's is even worse at 60. The climate's now set for an intriguing 2012. Hugh Rimmerton, 10 News.